Here we go with the true last part of question three in the IB quadratics test, IB1 that is, and it's probably the trickiest one, but again, drawing a picture can always help us. So again, we're looking for an equation of a quadratic function that contains the points negative 2, 6, 4, 6, and a y-intercept of negative 1, 3rd. So there's no information right now on a vertex, which we would use to build our equation using vertex form. There's no information yet on x-intercepts, which we would use to build our equation under factored form. So if neither of those are there sort of staring at us, why don't we start by drawing a quick picture? If we know we have a point at negative 2, 6, I'll just say that's about here, and 4, 6, that's on the same line but a little bit further, and then our y-intercept is negative 1 third, so I'll say that's somewhere down here. It's on the y-axis, negative 1 third. Okay, so this right here should show you what sort of shape it's going to be. We should also take note that since negative 2, 6 and 4, 6 are on the same level, we can, similar to how we do when we're given two x-intercepts, we can find the midpoint of those x values, and that must be our axis of symmetry. So the midpoint of negative 2 and 4, if we just take the average, that is 2 over 2, that equals 1. You can tell 1 is in between negative 2 and 4, so our axis of symmetry must be through here at x equals 1. Great. So we're already building this out. It clearly isn't going to go like this, because you wouldn't hit this point here. So you can already see sort of the shape it's going to take. It's going to be down like that. It's got to hit the vertex on this line, and then it's going to come back up and hit that. So that's the rules. If you get two points that have the same y coordinates, in this case these both have 6, the axis of symmetry has to be the average of those two x coordinates. Great, so we've got our axis of symmetry at x equals 1. So now what can we do? Well, we know that if we just think about, this could be a good one to use standard form. However, no matter what form you use, this is the hardest question because all we've got is information about the axis of symmetry. We do have 3 points, however, so what we're going to have to do is, if we take any form, let's take vertex form. So again, vertex form is y equals a into x minus h squared plus k. All we know about this right now is that h is 1, because we know the axis of symmetry contains the x value of the vertex. So far we've got y equals a into x minus 1 squared plus k. Okay, so now we can do sort of essentially a two equations, two unknowns situation. Because we don't know what k is, and because we don't know what a is, we need to use two of the points that we do know about and solve for a and k. So I'm going to plug in negative 2, 6, and 4, 6 for x and y in two different equations. So I'll get 6 equals a, we don't know, into x is negative 2 minus 1 squared plus k. So this gives us 6 equals negative 2 minus 1 is negative 3 squared is 9a plus k. So this is one equation. Now, imagine I subbed in 4, 6 for the second equation. Well, the problem is I would get this exact same equation, because 4 minus 1 is 3, squared is 9 again. So that's why we need this y-intercept information. So I'm going to plug in the points 0, negative 1, third for x and y. That'll be my second equation. So it'll be negative 1 third equals a, which we still don't know. X is 0 in this case, minus 1 squared plus k. Negative 1 third equals 1, negative 1 squared is 1a plus k. Okay, so now we've got one equation here, two equations here, and two unknowns, both a and k. So we should be able to use our solid algebra skills to solve for this. I'm going to use substitution. I'm going to isolate k in this first equation. So I'm going to do 6 minus 9a equals k. Then I'm going to sub that in for k here. And I'll get negative 1/3 equals a plus 6 minus 9a. I've just subbed in 6 minus 9a for k. Then you get negative 1/3 equals a, sorry, it'll be negative 8a plus 6. Running out of room. I'm going to move up here in orange. Subtract the 6 over and you get negative 1/3 minus 6 equals negative 8a. This is negative 19 over 3 equals negative 8a. So a equals 19 over 24. Not the nicest number, but at least we've got it. Okay, I'm going to erase a little bit here. Now we need to sub a back in to solve for k. So we said 6 minus 9a equals k right here. So k equals 6 minus 9 into 19 over 24. K equals 6 minus 57 over 8, if I've done my math right there. Which k equals, again, I'm just getting common denominators here, 48 minus 57 is negative 9 over 8. Hopefully you can check my algebra there. So we've got our a, we've got our k, so we can do our final equation. I will do some erasing here again, one sec. So our final equation, we'll leave it in vertex form, equals y equals 19 over 24, that's our a. We know x minus 1 is our, we know 1 is our axis of symmetry, so it has to be x minus 1 squared, minus 9 over 8, which would be the y-coordinate right here of the vertex. So this is the most difficult question they could possibly give you when it comes to building equations of quadratics. You had to know that the midpoint of the x values when two points share the same y values would be the axis of symmetry. So we took the midpoint of negative 2 and 4. We then have to take our other piece of information along with one of those points to plug into either vertex form, or it would have worked the same if you put it into factored form. You still would have had two variables to solve for. Since you need two variables to solve for, you need two equations, so we had to use two different points. Then we use our substitution or elimination method. This is, again, a tough question, especially because some of this algebra with fractions in here was tough, but it's using basically the same principles, and that last trick that they could possibly ask about is keep a heads up for those two points that have the same y values, because the average of the x's is the axis of symmetry. Hopefully this is helpful and you're ready to build any sort of quadratic function they ask you on the test.